everyone, I'm Chris Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by Rotimi Easyview. He's a product manager on Google Optimize. In this quick tip video, Rotimi is going to walk us through managing users and permissions in Google Optimize. So with that, I'm going to hand it over to Rotimi.
Thank you, Krista. Once you have your Google Optimize account and container, you're presented with this account view. From here, if you click on this user icon, then you have the option to manage various access levels as well as invite other people to join in your Optimize account. So once you're in this view, depending on the access level that you have, you will be able to see all of the users that have access to your account as well as the containers, the number of containers that they have access to. If you have admin permissions for each of these users, you can go in and view their account role as well as their container roles. Optimize offers three container roles, namely read, edit, and publish. A user that has read access to a container can only view pre-existing experiments. They do not have the ability to modify experiment data or create new ones. A user that has edit permissions can actually create experiments as well as modify experiment details such as targeting, objectives, etc. However, they do not have the ability to start experiments or stop experiments that are already running. A user with publish permissions, on the other hand, has full privileges and can edit, create, start, and stop experiments as needed. Another useful thing that you can do from this view is actually share access to your Optimize account with new users. To do so, click on the Invite Users button and then specify the email address of the user you would like to invite. So for example, a sample user. And once that is completed, you can then specify the account role you desire this user to have, either as a regular user or someone with admin privileges on that account. Additionally, for each of the containers available in this account, you can then specify the user's permission level, including the option for a user to have no access to a given container. And with that completed, that's it.
Great, thanks Rotimi for showing us how you would manage the various user permissions, as well as invite new users to your Google Optimize account.
Awesome, thanks Krista.